The Luxembourg government is creating legislation and providing $220 million in incentives for companies to begin mining asteroids. And Snotbot is a drone from DJI that is helping researchers study whales by safely and easily collecting their snot. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. GauntLev is a levitation glove. Bristol Interaction Group developed the gauntlet that uses acoustic levitation to allow a user to handle fragile or dangerous materials without touching them. They've also developed other acoustic levitation manipulation tools, including the sonic screwdriver and ultra tongs. Acoustic levitation was first mentioned in Mind Blow 50 back in September 2012 as a static system. These new tools allow for basic maneuvers and human controlling of levitating objects, representing a major leap forward for the technology. Also, it just looks awesome. Keeping busy in Bristol, researchers are developing a shape-changing handheld device. Cubimorph uses turntable hinges on cubes that can accommodate 6 touchscreens each, allowing for a variety of programmable shapes to provide modular interactivity. The successful proof of concept could lead to mobile phones transforming into game controllers as the materials and designs get smaller, cheaper, and sturdier. If you've ever wanted to hear the Milky Way, then thank an Asteroseismologist. Astrophysicists from the University of Birmingham measure tiny changes in the brightness of stars to determine their age and mass. They recently detected oscillations in the oldest known cluster of stars in our galaxy, at 13 billion years old. Here's what they sound like. Let's rock. It turns out snails use just 2 brain cells to make decisions. For example, one neuron encodes the presence of food, and another one gauges the snail's motivational state. So there's food and I'm hungry leads to let's eat. The study can lead to building new decision-making systems based on only 2 neurons. More specifically, robot brains. Exoskin is a shape-changing material that creates tangible interfaces with tactile feedback. Developed by the MIT Media Lab, the material consists of silicone triangles on flexible bladders that allow it to change texture. Their first proposed use for this would be a steering wheel that integrates GPS navigation directions naturally, so you can actually feel where you need to go. And ultimately, their plan is to break the divide of human-computer interaction, allowing people to physically interact with digital systems. Solar Impulse 2 is a single-seater, zero-fuel airplane, which recently landed safely in New York City after a trip across the Pacific Ocean and will next cross the Atlantic. It uses sun-powered solar cells to collect energy for charging lithium batteries during morning flights at altitudes up to 28,000 feet. At night, it glides to lower altitudes and uses the battery power until sunrise. They hope eventually it could someday provide a clean, renewable method of transportation. Mind Blow 82 in May 2014 featured Wi-Fi clothes. Along with Wi-Fi, the BB suit concept featured GPS and Bluetooth to turn your clothes into an MP3 player. Well, today there's a company called Machina that's making wearable technology, including a jacket that plays music in the hood using Bluetooth connected to your smartphone, and a new virtual reality jacket. The out-of-body experience jacket is embedded with sensors to allow the movement of your body to affect VR, turning the user into an immersive controller by wearing a normal-looking jacket instead of some weird suit. Finally, thanks to a new algorithm, humanoid robot Atlas can now detect partial footholds and autonomously adjust itself to stay balanced. I'm gonna leave you with a brain interface for controlling robot swarms. And as always, thanks for watching.
I can't hear much of anything. Sounds like someone crying. Oh, but my dear, you mustn't be so critical. Of course it sounds strange at first. The advertisement says it will.
Well, I don't think much of it. No one will ever use it.
You mark my words, dear. The time will come when we will all use it. Well, we may even talk with distant cities.
With distant cities? Oh, John, you're such a dreamer.